In this episode, let's check factories and constructors. Both these functions are used to create objects. The difference lies in how they create them. First, let's create an object using object literal. Here, I have declared a variable, my car, and I'm creating an object using object literals. What if I need another car? So I have to duplicate this code, right? This is my car, and that'll be another car, and that'll be another car. The code gets duplicated again and again if we require multiple cars. So instead of doing this, we can use functions. We can put this logic inside those functions. Whenever we require a car, we can use that function, right? Now let's change this way of object creation using constructors. This is it. Now we don't have to worry about duplication of codes. Function will take care of it. Since it's a constructor function, we need to name in Pascal case. I have put the properties inside the constructor function and methods inside prototype. This is because if you put your methods inside this constructor function, any objects get created, this method also will be created along with it. So if you have 5 objects, then these 5 objects will have 5 methods. It's kind of redundant. So we can put these methods inside prototype. We can inherit from the prototype. Inside this constructor function, you don't have to return anything. JavaScript will be doing it for you. Behind the scene, it will be creating an object and returning it. This refers to the object which gets created, right? And whenever you are calling a constructor function, you have to call with the keyword new. Now let's see the factory function. This is the factory function. It just returns an object. The difference is, in factory function, we are using return, and in constructor, we don't. JavaScript will be doing it for us. And in constructor, we have to use the keyword new, whereas in factory, we don't have to use it. Apart from this, there are other differences too. Let's check that now. I have console logged all the 3 objects. The first one is created using object literal, and the second one is using constructor, and third one is using factory. If you explore it, you can find one level of prototype. By default, every object gets the prototype of object constructor, right? And if you check the factory, this is also same as the one which we created using object literal. It has the one level of prototype. And if you check the constructor, you can find 2 levels of prototype. By default, constructor will give you a prototype from which it's get created. So we can also do the same inside the factory using a workaround, like by adding object.create method. Also, you can add private variables inside the factory functions.